Strange lady, she made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land of oil? A woman go and men may go. Can't you walk, can't you hear the thunder? You gotta run, you gotta take cover. We are living in a land of love. Women go and men may go. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. It's Casper from Brisbane here. So, I'm having some tech issues today. I'm really not sure what's going on today. But I had to move everything. I had to paint some walls where my builder had to... I knocked a hole out between two rooms to make my room bigger. And I had to paint the walls after the builder was done. And then I had to move all my computer stuff, my desk, my whole setup. Everything was unplugged and back on today. Oren, are you from... I'm just looking at the chat here. Sorry, I haven't even got my desk properly organized. Usually have everything on the right-hand side. Now I got stuff on the left-hand side. Oren Squishy. I like that. That's a pretty cool thing. Are you from the Jimmer chat by chance, I think? I remember an Oren over there. Anyway, I'm not too sure. Anyway, today my guest co-host is going to take some heat off me because I've been really, really slack. I haven't written anything down. I haven't got any dot points to discuss. It's just going to be completely on the fly today. It's going to be President Jeff Count from Count Country. So should I call Jeff or should Jeff call me? I think Jeff call me because I muted all my Skype sounds because I noticed that really comes out on the broadcast pretty shitly. So Jeff, give me a buzz on Skype. Hopefully, fingers crossed, it'll be working. Yes. Oren from the Jimmer chat. Yeah, cool. I remember I was talking to you just one particular night. Not sure whether you're just using a different profile, whether I knew you from before. Who knows? I think I was talking about how funny the Brain did a Periscope, and even Brain could appreciate this, where everybody was calling in and blowing up his phone, and it was a fucking funny bit. It was funny. So what else has been going on? I've been busy. I've been very, very busy. I don't see anybody calling me from Skype. Fuck, I hope my Skype is working. So last I spoke to people, I had my website up. Where I was posting. Yeah, that's right, the Bane Battles. Yeah, he's a hilarious bloke. I have my website up now, and I still haven't been able to do any testing as far as Discord is concerned, because I want to use Discord similar to the way that Jimmers does it. Can appreciate good tech, and he has the best that I've seen so far. I wish him Podrash is pretty good too. So another thing that I was battling was my internet just decided to fucking stop yesterday about 12:01 p.m. Couldn't work out why. I spoke to I'm with a company called Telstra, and they fucking suck. And I have what you call in Australia, it's the NBN, National Broadband Network, I think it stands for. But it's shitty. I actually had faster speed on cable at my old address, and up here I thought, oh, I'm going to get on this bloody NBN that everyone keeps talking about, get this great speed. Now, the speeds that I'm talking about in Australia are nothing compared to the speeds of the states and other countries. We have pretty... Oren, I have a server. Actually, I accidentally did two, and I can't even work out how to get rid of one, it's confusing, but I have got a server. I am set up, and just haven't had Jeff or Fancy help me do some testing yet. But I will get into it. I'm quite happy with Skype. Group calls on Skype are pretty good or work well for me. They seem to come out okay. Sometimes I notice when people connect and stuff, it sounds really, really bad. And I notice with Skype, you know, people sort of tend to over-talk each other, and it comes out, like, shitty. And I notice on Discord, there can be, like, three or four people on there, and the it seems to work really well as far as coming out decent. And from listening to them, I can tell that Jim is constantly adjust stuff, mics and levels and stuff, so I'm not really sure how that's done, but I'm interested to learn a little bit more about that. Especially, there's people, I don't have a Skype number, I just have a, you know, contact list, and people contact me. If you're on my list, you can add me. I think I'm just, I just use my, one of my emails, as my addy. There's a few Dazzers and Darrens and all that sort of shit in Brisbane, but it's the one with the Aussie Rules logo, Casper in Brisbane. So, if anyone wants to chat on Skype, I don't really care, as long as you're not a mean, mean troll or anything. I don't really mind whether, you're somebody that, isn't friends with someone that I am. That doesn't bother me. That's something else I need to get into tonight, that I wanted to talk about. I was actually going to talk to Jeff about that, because Jeff can definitely relate to, having friends and enemies or frenemies or whatever you want to call them. So, but getting back to the Telstra thing, it's just like, I got this modem, right, and it's got three green lights on the top and, I don't know, two at the front or something, and then when the lights, the lights went out, and it had nothing to do with me moving my stuff around, because I didn't really move the modem or change any cables or anything. So I was on the chat line with Telstra, and then, one person tells me there's a problem with NBN, so just wait a while, blah, 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 3-4 hours go past, nothing, gets down to the Saturday night peak time, evening time, and you would have thought that if they were doing some sort of planned maintenance that it would have been up and running by then, and that wasn't. And then my mum got home, and she's crazy about, like, just playing Facebook games and stuff like that, so no internet is very frustrating for her. She'd got home from work and likes to sit in front of the TV and do that. And so I followed it up a little bit more. I decided to call somebody instead of just the chat line, so I was calling them. And then they tell me that they all do the same thing. They all do the line testing. They all get you to do a reset. We did a hard reset of the router. They all get you to do exactly the same thing, because they all think they're experts at fixing stuff, but they're not. And it's not until the call gets passed higher up in the chain, you know. So then they said to me that frenemies. Yeah, it's a term we use over in Australia. I don't know if they use it elsewhere. And then they tell me that, with my experience, I thought it was the router. There's something wrong with the router. It's a cheap router, right? They're made in absolute bulk, and they hand them out, to Australia people. So I reckon, like, I went on eBay and I priced them. They're probably worth about $40, and that's not a great router. But that's the one that I have, and, I'll stick with it for now. Anyway, getting back to the speeds. I don't want to sound, I'm almost embarrassed to let everybody know what the sort of speeds of the internet are in Australia. Now, the best speed you can get as far as, like, the NBN is 100 meg per second, whatever it is, which is really fast. I had cable modem at my other house, and I used to get 30. 30 was good, but the upload was really, really bad, but the download was okay, right? So, for broadcasting, I've discovered that upspeed is really, really important as well. Now, I moved here, and I was under the illusion that I was going to get 50, right? 50, I thought, wow, 50, from 30 to 50, I almost got like 50, 100%, almost, And I thought, wow, it's going to be good. So eventually, I have the NBN all ready here. I move over here and I set it all up and I get it working and I got all the lights on. I went like, oh, fuck, man, it's there. Now I just got to set everything up, blah, blah, blah. So we connected the Wi-Fi devices. So we got, I've got an iPhone, I've got an iPad. Mum's now got an iPhone and she's already got an iPad. That's it. So we've got four devices here at home. And then when my nieces come over, all their devices connect. So, it was pretty good. Wi-Fi was not too bad, but obviously hardwired is always better. So the modem is actually in my room right next to me. So I hardwired from the modem to my computer. So I would get slightly better speed. So I've got slightly better speed. Okay. So I started to do like the old Google speed test. So I did a speed test and it's coming up with, it's coming up with like 22 or 23, it depends on the time of the day, right? I'm kind of like, oh, this is worse than the other house. And that house is okay, but I was really expecting to get more because I picked like this package that includes Foxtel, which is pay TV. Don't know what you guys call it over there. So I've got two Foxtel boxes. I've got one in my room here. I got one in the lounge room. So, and with the unlimited, broadband, home phone, and I think my mum's mobile is on the account as well, but mine's not. Anyway, it was something like $200 a month or something like that, which for over here is pretty good. So I would expect for that, which is slightly cheaper than what I was paying before at the other house with the package I had over there, which had expired but never changed the package. So we weren't on contract. But we went on contract when we came here. So I got 2 years of this shit. And I get my shit set up. I jump on the Telstra chat line and I start complaining, saying like, the speed is slower than what I had before. I said, I'm looking to improve as time goes on, not go backwards. So they after like three or four of these complaints, me logging on and all, I think they got sick of me. One of the lady goes, okay, we're going to, we'll peg on the evening boost or something, but we'll have it like 24/7. I went, oh, a boost, okay. But I don't want to pay anymore because I've already got this expensive package. She goes, oh, don't worry. We will give you the package for free. So anyway, I went, okay. She goes, oh, but please give it 1 to 2 hours to take effect. Oh, yeah, I'm not in any hurry. That's fine. Anyway, so she applies this package, right? So I start doing speed tests like a day later, right? And and to this day, I'm still doing speed tests. Now I'm getting 27 to 28. So obviously, I think she told me it was going to go up to 30 or something. Anyway, so at this same time, I start reading about the NBN, right? And the NBN has told all its providers that with all new accounts, the minimum that you can offer somebody is 50 megabytes per second, I think it is. And here I am sitting on like, I was on like a 25. The 25 is the basic, absolutely dead basic package of the speed level. And I keep telling everyone, I want 50. I want fucking 50. And I still can't get it. Now, last night when I was complaining about the net being down, I made up this bullshit that I need it for work, but I really don't need it for work. I just need it for doing this sort of shit. She told me that she's going to, this other lady, because, you get a different person every time. And these people aren't like just Aussies that you can speak to that can relate or anything. They're people in other countries that have been taught to, all they do is apologize. They just, all the time, just fucking apologize but they don't say, oh, we apologize for the shitty service. They just say things like, oh, we completely understand, Darren, I was going to say my name, and we apologize for any inconvenience caused, and blah, blah, and, but don't worry, we will get to the bottom of this, and it's just the same story every time. I've probably complained 10 times since I moved to this address, and I've only been here for 4 months. So, last night, the lights just start coming back on. But they weren't, it wasn't fixed. And then like, it was about 10 o'clock at night last night. And, I get this message from my mum, like, and she's already gone to bed and she goes, oh, it's back on. I don't know. She must've got some notification through and woke her up or something. So I jump up and I went like, oh, yeah, the lights are on, blah, blah, blah. But then after a while, like, one would go off. So they're obviously still, you know, fixing a fault somewhere in the line. But it's working now, obviously, because I'm on. And so far, so good. I did a speed test. Still got the same sort of speed. Up there was 27, 28. So I imagine that hopefully they'll follow it up during the week, because I actually told them, I said, you know, follow it up. Like, I'd really like to get this speed, blah, blah, blah. And because one person says, oh, your line's maxed out, like, thing, you know. And they got this, like, it's called fiber to the node or something. So I think it's fiber from your street, from the street to the node. And the node is like a little green box, apparently, that's at the end of every street. And it depends where you are in the street and how far away the box is to the exchange as to what sort of speed you're going to get. And also, the wire from the street to your house also has, I guess, its limitations as well. So you're all governed and factored by those points. So I imagine that, you know, if you live right near the exchange and you've got like a new house, you're probably going to have fucking great speed. But if you live in an older house, I mean, I don't know, my house I just brought here is probably, I don't know, I haven't even looked at the history, but, you know, it's probably, it's probably 15, 20 years, maybe 15, 10, 15 years old. I don't know. I'll have to look it up. But so I don't know what sort of cabling. It's probably got the old-fashioned, actually looking at the connections at the wall when I moved in, it's probably got like the old-fashioned telephone type cable. You know, and I mean, if it's a case of just running new cable or whatever, I mean, I would get it done if someone would just tell me what I needed to do instead of just saying, oh, you're governed by what you got. They don't give you any options like, hey, Darren, do you want to run, if you're willing to pay $250 and run cable from your house to the street, we'll connect you up. We'll guarantee you that you're going to get 50. You know, if they said something like that, I'd say, if I can do it here, here's the money. I'll write your check right now. But they don't do that. So anyway, Mr. Count, have you been trying to call me? Because nothing's coming up on my screen. And we should talk about... I wanted to talk to you about... oh my God, Ren, you're 400. You're fucking shitting me. That's incredible. I'm working with friggin' 30. That's incredible. Tell me in the chat what you're paying for... for that, like, you know, and I know it's a Aussie versus US or whatever. Well, that's, yeah, it is horrible, you know. And now they're experimenting with I don't know what technology level you guys are up to, but they're now saying that they're experimenting with 5G out here. They're doing tests on 5G. So, but I've even got even funnier fucking news for you. You're not going to believe this, right? I buy this house in a normal street. Yeah, I'd shoot if you had 30. Yeah, thank you. I live in a normal street, right? In a decent suburb, the outskirts of this suburb, right? I used to live at Strathpine, but I don't live there anymore. And you're not going to believe it. Mum and I, right? This is my house. Mum, I brought this house and Mum lives here. I brought this house and we started to, like, use our... oh, wow, 75, that's pretty fucking good. I brought this house, right, you're not going to believe it, the mobiles weren't really that good, our mobiles, like, we didn't have fantastic reception. This is another really shitty story. You're going to cry when you hear this one, Aaron. You're going to fucking cry. We only got, like, one or two bars, and phone calls was dropping out, and I started noticing, going, like, why is the reception of our mobile so shitty here, because we're on 4G, right? But every now and then it just like flicks to 3G, 4G, whatever, right? So I start looking into that. I do this investigation, right? You're not going to believe it. I'm on the edge of an arc. I'm in the middle of an arc of what they pretty much call the dead zone. So I'm basically right on the border of a dead zone. In other words, they haven't gone further out to extend the coverage, right? Even though they say all these networks in Australia, Telstra, Vodafone, all those telcos, they all say that they are covering you know, 95% of Australia, you know. Okay, I must be in this fucking percent that I'm living on the dead zone. So last night I made some calls to the helpline, and it worked okay. I didn't get cut off. They have my number anyway, but I didn't get cut off, right? But my mum makes calls from the lounge room, and she can't sit in the lounge room and make calls. She has to sit outside just to give that little bit more. If you go outside, if you go down, say, to the end of the driveway out the front, which is only like 20, you know, 30 feet, whatever, then your call won't drop out. But there's even instances where people have called and, okay, fancy, I can see you there, buddy. What part of Australia? I'm in Brisbane. Everyone knows it's Casper in Brisbane. I'm on the north side of Brisbane. And I'm not in the outback. I don't have kangaroos running around. I don't have fucking wombats on the doorstep or anything like that. I'm just in a normal suburb, normal street, on the north side of Brisbane, about an hour from Brisbane. So there's really, in my opinion, no excuse. I'll tell you. I'll tell you who sings the song. Don't ask me why that song came into my mind, but the other day, I always play like a song that leads into my intro, and I always try to pick a different song. And I decided to, this song came in my head, and I thought, wow, I haven't heard that song for ages. But if you look it up, the original is someone called Gino Vanelli. So if you look up Gino, G-I-N-O, Vanelli, V-A-N-N-E-L-L-I, Gino Vanelli sings the original Wild Horses Will Not Drag Me Away. So, you're a funny bastard. So, so I hope that info helps you download. I just downloaded the song. I like the song too. I haven't heard it for years. It's an older song. It's been around for a while. So anyway, let me see whether I can, I'm going to call my friend. I'm not sure. Yeah, I turned all my Skype sounds off, so it won't come through on the Periscope. That's good. So I'm ringing Jeff now because he didn't call me. And he said he was ready, but I've been waffling on here for friggin' a while now. And, hello, is that Mr. Jeff Count?
Hey now!
Hey, buddy, how are you? Are you okay now? I asked you to call, but I didn't. I thought, oh, well, I'll just wait for you to call. And I waited for a while, and I thought, better call you.
I was waiting for you to give me the okay.
Oh, sorry. I'm having a few little glitches getting everything set up again.
Yeah, I'm just seeing. At first, I was hearing a feedback, but now it seems to be all right now.
Okay. Yeah, sorry, man. I really wasn't 100% confident of doing this today because I didn't quite have everything set up and to my liking, and I like to be like, you know, somewhat semi-professional, but
yeah, this is prepared.
Oh, okay. I mean, I know a lot of people go on and they have technical difficulties, but I like to like do things nicely so they look nice, you know. I think I'll have to look back on it. If I fucked up anywhere or something's not coming out, I won't post it. But anyway, buddy, yeah, I did promise that I'd do my best. So I'll just tell you what I've done. I had to paint this whole wall. I had to move the desk out of the way, right? So I got this quite big desk. I've got two big screens, fucking big-ass computer, all my fucking, you know, mixer and mics and everything. I had to pull everything apart. Every single cable had to come apart, put the stuff to the side. I had to take the desk apart because it's so fucking big. I had to unscrew the desk, take it completely apart, move it out of the way because my room, I joined two rooms together, but my room is more like a sort of rectangle, not really a big square. It's a sort of rectangle. So I had to paint this wall, and basically, I just had to move everything out of the way. So I moved everything out of the way. I painted the wall. I had to go and buy some paint because, you know, I've just brought this house, so I'm not familiar with what fucking color it was. So I had to go and take the old paint tin down to the Bunnings Hardware and get some more paint, come back. Put the drop sheet down. I had fucking paint on me, and fucking cleaning up is even water-based paints are difficult to clean up. You know, you just make a mess.
Yeah.
You just make a mess everywhere. And so anyway, I got the wall painted, and it came out pretty good. And then I had to decide how to set my room up. So I've moved my room completely around a different way. I'm happy with it, and yeah. I started.
Holy shit, you've been busy, mate.
Yeah, but also. As you, I'm not sure if you've been listening, but my internet went out yesterday as well. So I thought that
I
was.
I think I seen you post a tweet about saying that something about that.
Yeah, I was on my phone. I was just using obviously data to do Twitter and stuff like that. But my fucking internet went down, and I had to whinge, and finally late last night it came back up. So this is a test.
It happens. It happens with me now and then. Not too often, but. You know,
Jeff, what sort of speed are you getting there in Canada? What sort of internet speed are you getting?
I don't know. I've got the one of the top of the line high speed, they say, and I can get one that's faster, but there's certain, you know, I said no, I want a good high speed. I don't know, like I'd have to
okay.
Like I'm sure there's a thing I can go into and find out, right? I know they call it the silver something or
no. I can tell. Oh, yeah. Your package. Yeah. Now, if you want to do that when you get chance, just Google speed test and then just run what the one of the speed tests, and it just tests your speed, and it'll just like it's like a speedo and just tell you. It just tells you your speed. Yeah, it tells you your speed. So, I'm just curious to know what sort of speed you get, because I know the Americans get fucking fantastic speed. Ren was just telling me that they get 400 megabytes per second. I mean, that's fucking insane. The top, the best speed here for personal is like 100, and you have to pay like $100+ a month for that.
I'll definitely check into it. If I go on to, I'm with Rogers. That's what they call it here. Rogers cable and,
yeah,
I've got a package, and supposedly I've got one of the top speeds. But there is one other one I can go to. It's a little bit extra money, but I'm fine with the speed I got.
Yeah, yeah. Well, yeah.
You say I can just Google. What'd you say to Google?
Just Google speed test.
Speed test.
Yeah. Just Google speed test, and you can. It'll come up with a few different sites that just basically you just click go, and what it does, it just pings back. It just pings back your, and gives you a speed. I wouldn't be surprised if you were getting 100 or something, 100+. I don't know what Canada's like, but that's awesome. Yeah, Fancy's on the train, so I imagine he's going to work at the moment, I would say. So unfortunately, we can't have Fancy on today unless he calls in.
He's telling you that he takes a train. He's got to take a train to work, right?
Yeah, yeah, to and from. Yeah, I believe so. And he starts about 10. He starts about 10, which is way past his time because it's probably almost 11. Yeah, I don't know, man. You know, Fancy.
I haven't seen him on. Post on Twitter or post any Periscopes or
no, you
SoundCloud
remember,
or
you
anything.
You remember last week he said he was busy, very busy with the, what do you call it, the summer season or something, with his with the shop. He said he was going to be very busy, but yeah, I haven't seen any little shows or anything.
Well, that's good. It's good for him to get a little busy. Like I get busy too, and I don't. I'm not on here a heck of a lot, but when I'm not busy, I might spend a little bit more time on here, right? So it's kind of good for him to get away from it. Kind of the internet sometimes will make you go a little bit crazy, you know what I mean? It's good to get out, and whether you're working or going out with friends or family, you know. So a lot of people are just like don't concentrate too much on this crazy internet world.
Yeah,
and, spend far too much time.
That's what I want
to make you go crazy. That's not healthy, I don't think.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about, actually. Like, you know, there's some people that obviously have far too much time on their hands, and sometimes, you know, like I jump on and off, right? And I'll not scroll back and read like whole conversations, you know how, and then you don't get the whole picture, and then sort of like somebody will say something at the end of the stream, and you sort of think, okay, and then you reply back, and suddenly you're tagged in.
I don't have time. I understand exactly what you're saying, and I definitely don't have time to be keeping up with, you know, people will say something, and I don't know what they're talking about. It, you know, I'd have to go back like maybe a day or two, or, you know, like their conversations, right?
Yeah. Well, your favorite friend and foe, she seems to love fighting with people. But anyway.
Well, there's a lot of people on here like that. Mm. But I seriously, I'm a lot better than I used to, but it's kind of stay away from the you know, the bashing and all that. It's like, it's funny because I got a chance to watch a little bit. Brain went live on his YouTube channel the other night.
Yeah, that's
and I got a chance to catch a little bit of that. And I'm just thinking to myself, I'm going, you know what? Is it bashing with the brain? Is this is going to be his thing? I just kind of felt bad for the guy because, you know what? There's so much more you can do. Do a podcast to like have a topic or talk about interview people, like have it, do a show, like, yeah. It's the same thing. Get on there and start bashing people, like, yeah, you know,
but
what I mean?
Yeah, but
like, remember, when I did my fire talks and that, like, I tried to do a show, you know what I mean? Like, put on a show. I had like games or trivia or music or interview somebody, you know, have a topic, like. But it's a lot of these guys are just like, even Jimmer, you know, they go back and forth calling each other, like, it's kind of getting ridiculous. Yeah. Don't you think?
Well, that's his bit, though.
There's time for bashing, but you know, that's all it is, though. The whole show is just about, you know.
but with
people.
Don't you find that's like funny to watch? I mean, I would never do it, and I'm not, you know, I'm not contributing to it.
It's been going on too long. Like, you got, what happened to putting on a show? Like, having a series. Like, this is why I love your Aussie Rules,
yeah,
man.
You
know what? We talk about, you know, like, we have topics, and we have conversations, good discussions about stuff. We're not always, like, talking about, you know, this person, that person, and this person said that, and that person is bashing that person, and, you know, it's, you know, come on. You know, there's more to life to talk about than, you get the point.
Look, if we talk about Brian, whatever you want to call him, it's complicated, you know. It's complicated because there's a few of us sort of always got along well with Brian,
yeah.
And I only ever interfered once on Rabbit when he was sort of going a little bit overboard with Ava, but that's his thing, you know. Like, I'm not gonna get involved in people's fights, you know, like Brain's fighting, you know, with Crystal or I don't know if it's fake fighting or whatever,
yeah,
and Brain's fighting with the Jiminan and all that sort of stuff. I'm not getting involved because, you know what, I like all these people, so.
Yeah, go ahead. I was just gonna say, this is exactly what we're talking about just before that, about people having too much time on their hands. Do you notice all these people, they don't work? They're either collecting, like Brain, he's not working, right?
He's
collecting something, and Jimmerman's doing the same thing, and most of all these people, of course, I'd do the exact same thing if I wasn't working, and if I was collecting something, I'd be on the computer, right? It's addictive, you know? You got no life, but still, I'm trying to get the fuck out of the door and trying to mix and mingle with friends and family.
But Jeff, like, one side can't see the other. So if you're a worker, a full-time worker like you or me, we use the internet in our spare time to entertain ourselves, right?
Yeah.
Right? For a laugh. right? It's all about having fun, having a laugh, meeting people from around the world, blah, blah, blah. Now, if you're not working and this is all you have, and work is not an option for whatever reason, whether it's a disability or whether you just don't want to work, whatever, then online is all you have. That is the main thing. So if you take that away, see, I feel a little bit, you know, sorry for Brain, because all he had was online stuff. And I don't care whether it's the rabbit stuff or whether it's the GPN thing. That's all he had, that he put his effort into there, and then it got taken away from him by no fault of his own. And he's an angry guy. He's a very, very...
He
has his issues, and he knows that. I mean, he's not going to get upset with
him. Brain is around the same age as me and you.
Yes.
And,
yes.
And we grew up in an area where there wasn't internet, you know. Most of the time we were growing up, we didn't have the internet.
I didn't have the internet until I was
But I'm saying maybe the internet is kind of a good thing for, because Brain's kind of an addictive personality, right? He's got a gambling problem and a hooker problem or whatever before that, right? So imagine if he didn't have the internet.
Yeah.
He'd be out gambling or doing hookers, right?
I think that's in the past.
You got to fill up your time somehow, right? Because he's not working, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, like you said, he's got to fill up his time. He's gonna, like, I'd be on the internet too. It's addictive, you know. I'm just saying. When I grew up, like when I went to school and I had to hand in a project, I couldn't go on the internet. I had to go to the. I had encyclopedias.
Yeah.
I had to read those damn encyclopedias to write my reports, right?
Yeah.
Like print one up, like some of these kids, I think it's just so easy for them just to do homework. Just with the internet alone is a major advantage they had over us, right?
I'll be honest, when I was a kid, I was playing with my fucking Matchbox, you know, toys, cars and stuff in fucking dirt, mate. I was lucky to have a pool, like an above ground pool when I was younger. Like they're the things that I remember the most, you know. I don't remember any of this internet stuff. I didn't have internet until I was freaking in my 30s, probably. I mean, fuck.
So are you on the scope live?
Yeah.
Okay, because I'm not logged into that. I'm just logged into the Skype. But I want to ask you about the you know what I'm talking about? What I just like joined up,
like oh, I the just di- down- Discord.
The Discord. Okay, now the Discord. I was trying to figure out. Do you have to have somebody's 4-digit code at the end of their name to try and get to go into their Discord? Like if I wanted to go into Jimmerman's Discord,
I have to have
4 numbers. Thing,
okay.
Right?
No. Okay. So this is how it works. There's like a invitation that you can send out from Discord. It's like an invitation to join.
I got that, but what do I type in there? I type in.
There's an invite that doesn't expire, right? So if like the one on my website, for instance, should be a non-expiry link. So if you click on it, it goes basically straight into my Discord. And then I think I have to accept you or something. Kleenex went into my Discord and I accept him, but then he left again. So you can come and go out of Discord. What we'll do is when we're offline one time, because this is what I wanted to do with you and Fancy. I wanted you two guys at the same time to jump in my Discord, and then I wanted to talk. It's the same as this, the same as what we're doing now. We need to do it in Discord because I want to incorporate that into my podcast.
Yeah. I seen him in there and I did put an invite.
Okay.
I'd seen you got Fancy.
Yeah, that's about
is in there. And I was able to like send an invite.
Okay.
You know,
all right.
To Fancy, but he never.
We'll work it out together because I must admit I'm a little bit green on it as well. So we'll work it out together.
But I couldn't figure out how to get, because when I was watching it, Jimmeran, last night, because he was posting pictures of, you know, stuff I wanted to see. And he said to people, he said, go into my Discord.
Yep.
I said, well, like, I wasn't in the mood for like asking them in chat or anything like that. But so I went into my thing, and I just, it says, you know, they need the his the four digit code after his name.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. No. There's a
I don't know.
There's a better way of doing it. At the bottom of any Jiminen videos, if you scroll down, you'll see like his Discord link.
And
And you can just
click... On his YouTube?
Yeah, on his YouTube, yeah.
I'll figure it out from there.
If you click on... If you click on there...
I just want to see those pictures, like...
Which one's the crystal ones you're talking about?
No, I wasn't... No, I'm not interested in looking at crystal. he's got... that kitty girl and...
Oh, right, yeah.
Like supposedly they've got like nude pictures in there that they post in deep. They've got no problem posting them in.
No, because it's private. It's a private thing. You can't get reported for it. It's perfect. It's a perfect thing to use.
I heard Lori was on there too, and she was posting pictures of supposedly Brian's penis. Brian's claiming that wasn't his; he was just trolling her.
Yeah, I know. You have to have Discord. Yeah, I'm in Jimmer's Discord, but I haven't got it open at the moment. But yeah, once you're in there, you're in there. Like you if you just stay in there, you stay in there. Like if they kick you out, then you can join back up. Like I got kicked out the first time, but I don't think because that no one knew who I was until Jiminen said. Oh, yeah, Casper's okay, blah, blah, blah. So now I'm not getting kicked out now. Because there's a lot of moderators there. That
he knows me. I've called in to show quite a while ago. I called in once, and I just called in to tell him that I thought that his guitar playing was pretty good. So I was just I did mention about his glasses, that he should take his glasses off. I didn't bother him too much. I just...
Yeah, I meant to ask him about the glasses. Actually,
I asked him. That was my first call. I asked him about the glasses.
Did he? What did he say? I'm curious.
He says that his eyes are. He's embarrassed about his eyes. I think he's Korean. Actually, Brian keeps saying Asian, Korean. I heard him mention Korean, but his eyes they're slanted, right? They're embarrassed about their eyes. And it's supposedly somebody told me he's got a lazy eye too, so it's why he's wearing those glasses all the time. I don't know.
No, that's fair enough. I did hear that some Asian people are not happy with their eyes, but I don't understand.
I know that. I know. You're right about that. I know a lot of Asians that have gotten their eye surgery to open up their eyes.
Wow.
You know? Wow. The one, Connie, is her name Connie Chung? It's the girl that is on The Voice, or that talk show host. She admitted of getting it done because they're embarrassed. They just, you know, it's all stereotyping. They just got to get over it. You know, you should be happy with, you know, that's the way you're born. You know, that's your nationality.
Hey, listen, you know,
there's a reason for everything.
I wanted to run something past you, just getting back to that Twitter stuff. I wanted to ask you something. Have you ever been in a situation like this where, you know, you've been friends with, say, someone for a long time, on Twitter, and it's online, I know, it's not real life, so we got to keep it in perspective here, it's online stuff. And that person, you know, has haters of their own, but you don't have any problem with the people that are hating on this person. What do you do? Mm-hmm. What do you do when you don't want to be, you know, you don't want to be taking sides, because then you're losing online friends, if you know what I mean, where you don't have any problems with them. They haven't done anything to you, or they just don't, you know, people just have these beefs with people that you don't have any problems with. It's like, you know, being guilty through association, just because... You know, you want to be friends with and take me for instance. I am friends with most people. There is a few people that I don't like. There is a few people that I genuinely don't like. And you know, someone say like a Crimson or Mike Koff, or you know, someone like that, that I just don't like them. I just don't like their personality or whatever.
I understand exactly what you're saying.
Yeah. What do you do in that situation? Those people get the shits with you. Like both sides of those people get the shits with you.
I'll be perfectly honest with you. I tell them straight. I tell them straight out. I go, look at you. You've got a problem with this person. That's between you and them. You know, it's nothing to do with me. I don't tell you who to love. I'm totally up front with them. And if they don't like that, I'm like, if somebody really hates you, that's their problem. You know, like if you got a problem with me associating with Casper, then you know what? Then that's your problem, dude. You know, like I'm straight up. I'm totally honest. You know, I'm not going to dislike. Like you, like let's say you become really good friends with Crimson. Like I wouldn't be too happy about it, but I'm not gonna stop being your friend just because of that. You know,
yeah,
that's between you and her, right?
Yeah, it's happened in more than one situation. It is happening with Crystal. Crystal is one of the people, only one of the people, but I'll get other people saying to me, Casper, guilty by association. I get people saying to me, oh, why do you do this, or why do you say that about, you know, thing. I don't have any issues. Like,
I had an argument with John M.
Yeah,
a long time ago on Rabbit about this, and because John M. was saying, no, you gotta pick a side, Jeff.
Yeah,
I go, no, I don't, John. But that was a long time ago, and I think that, you know, we talked that through, and I said, oh, yeah, John was saying, yeah, you're right. You shouldn't be fucking telling people they got to pick a side. That's just, you know, yeah.
Like, I go into, say...
That's high school shit, man.
Jeff, I'll give you a good example. Like, he's a good example, right? I go into, say, a Jimmerman show, whatever, whether it be live or whatever. It is hard for me to catch live shows, but... and they, most of them, some of those people in Jirinen are from the old High Pitch Eric live chat stream that was going on for a while. Anyway, they're all a mix of people that have come together, right? And Jirinen doesn't like Crystal. Well, I don't really know if he doesn't like her, but he gives her a lot of shit and tore her up and all that sort of stuff. Because anybody that was on GPN, not so much associated with GPN, but that anyone that was on GPN is basically, you know, his enemy sort of thing, and he was, you know, ripping her a new asshole, and I watch that stuff. I don't jump in the chat and say, oh yeah, fucking Crystal's this and Crystal's that, because I don't have any fucking reason to dislike Crystal. We have had our ups and downs. Fancy wants to be added to the core. I don't know how this is going to work. Hang on a second, Fancy. Hang on a second. Let me finish the conversation, and then we'll change topics. So I can't do anything about, I can't do anything about these people ripping Crystal a new asshole, right? But if I'm even, like the other day, I was in the chat, talking, not trashing, and sort of Crystal gets annoyed that I'm even there, you know, and I'm not supporting it. I'm just watching the fucking thing. I don't see anything wrong with that.
A lot of times, I'll be honest with you, a lot of times I don't say anything. Like if I got my own opinion about a certain person, but I know that, you know, it there's no point in me starting a fucking war or anything. I just don't say anything, you know,
Oh, I was watching Brain stuff, right? I was watching Brain. Brain's, right, you know, Brain's really making a lot of, you know, enemies or whatever, but he doesn't give a shit, right? That's his whole bit. He loves stirring up people, yeah. Right? So I watch his stuff, but I don't go in the chat and start supporting what he's saying. I just watch it. I'm just watching it. I'm not doing anything. I'm just watching it. So I hate when people then say, people see me in the chat there and they say, how can you watch this shit, or... blah, blah, blah. And I was just like, hey, it's fucking slightly amazing.
I could say to them, how do you watch fucking Kleenex? I think that's garbage. But I'm not going to stop being friends with those people just because they watch Kleenex. I think Kleenex is a fucking bore.
Yeah, well, I can't stand
I can't stand people that are not real. He's fake to me. So I choose not to watch him. But I'm not going to be mad at the people that... that like them and want to go and
Jeff,
watch them.
You and me are working full time, right? I don't sit at home and watch all these people, right? What I do is, if I can download it and put it on my phone, I listen to the shit while I'm working. You know, it's the only way I can keep up with shit. I don't sit at home, you know, on the dole or disability watching all these people. I just listen to it as I'm working. Even if it's YouTube, you know, a replay on YouTube, I'll just put my headphones in, blah, blah, blah. Now, usually when, or a Periscope, I'll watch a replay of a Periscope. But the thing is, though, these people, they all go in there and see who watched the Periscope. And then they judge you based on, like, oh, yeah, Casper watched my Periscope or whatever.
I wouldn't even know how to fucking look for that. I'm not.
You know
I'm
what
not
I mean? Like, they all look at who watched them, and then they say, oh, this person watched me, so they must like me, whatever. That's not necessarily the case. I might watch it, right? If someone titles their Periscope, fuck Ava's a cunt, you know, which I saw someone do the other day or something, I'll go like, oh, I want to hear what she said about her. You know what I mean? Like, doesn't mean I support it.
Oh, yeah.
And I've watched... And by the way, you know, I just saw Ren post something in the chat there. Just said I don't know if it's a he or she. Well, Skimmerman, the very first time he went on...
Yeah, so was I.
Yeah, the very first time he went on GPN, I fucking picked up on that show straight away because it was Howard Stern related. He said it was talking about Howard Stern or something.
And not only that,
through the whole fighting,
he does. He's really good with his audio and his equipment and the stuff. Like he's pretty damn good at what he does.
He's fucking perfect. You know? He's spot on. His tech is fucking absolutely phenomenal, man. If I lived anywhere near him, I would suck his resources to find out how he fucking does that shit. I would love someone to show me how they do that. I love to know how they do that, man. But anyway, we'll have to do it. Until then, we do our shit.
Is Fancy sending... Can you fix that thing with Fancy?
Yeah, okay. All right. I'm adding him to the group call, so he'll probably come on here in a minute and interrupt us, but that's...
Why I'm on for twice.
He'll come on in a second.
Okay.
Hello?
Oh. How's it?
Hello, Fancy. Welcome to Auzzie Rules.
Hey, I just wanted to tell you that I'm on a train, man.
you just wanted me to ring you.
So that you can believe me. Can you hear?
We believe you, buddy.
No. Oh, okay. No, because I didn't want you guys to think I'm being funny and I don't want to come onto the scope. You know what I mean? I'm in and out of tunnels here. Can you hear?
Yeah,
loud on my part.
Yeah, so if I talk now, then I won't be able to hear you guys. So how long are you guys going to be on?
We're just winging it, right?
Yeah, we're winging it today. It's not very structured today, but
not scheduled.
Are you on your way home, Fancy, or you?
Give me 10 minutes.
Are you on your way home, or you were on your way to work?
I'm on my way home.
On your way home. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, you'd send me a message when you want to jump back on, all right?
Okay.
All right, buddy. All right. All right. He hung up himself. He'll probably just be able to join himself when he wants.
I just want to let you. Do you know we're so in Canada? It's the marijuana is supposed to be legalized come July 1st, right?
Oh, really?
That's the day that's the date they set. Now they're saying August 1st. So they keep pushing it back, right?
Sorry, Jeff. Is that for medical or what? What do you?
No, that's for everybody.
Wow.
In Canada.
Holy
shit. Yeah, and it was always supposed to be July the 1st. Now they've pushed it back there. Just read it on the internet. You know what? If you Google it, just Google the legalization of marijuana in Canada. You'll see it. You'll see Justin Trudeau has announced that it's got to be pushed to August 1st because there's just too much preparation involved, right? They're saying.
So, Jeff, are you telling me that you can, once it's legalized, you can just go to a store and you can just buy a certain amount?
They've already online, they've already posted what stores are going to be available, where they are located, what's going to be there. It's going to be like vending machines even.
Wow.
You know? Yeah. Quite amazing. It's Canada's.
Are you gonna? Oh, I'm not sure, Jeff. Are you a pot smoker, like, at all, or are you?
Not really.
Are you gonna
Not
wait?
really.
Yeah, but if it's legal, why not, right?
It makes me kind of paranoid. I used to when I was younger, but I'm all. If I have a few drinks and I can handle like a few puffs or whatever, but if I'm not, I think the
Actually, you know
alcohol
what?
kind of levels it off for me, right?
You
Other than
do.
that, it makes me paranoid.
Well, the thing is, though, I think it's anything. Actually, just now that you just said that, you just reminded me of something. I accuse you of being a little bit paranoid in the past. You know, when you get on the booze. So maybe that's something that happens to you when you take a drug of some kind.
Well, the marijuana used to get like if I take too much of it, like I would get bed spins and all that shit, right? So, I and a lot of people told me, he says, "Oh, you're just not used to it yet. You gotta, your
Just
body's not used to it because See, I could take a couple of hits and I could get as high as somebody else like Ryan. He would have to take like three bongs before he'd get that buzz that I get just from taking two hits because his body's already immune to it. It's
yeah.
already used to it, right?
I was just asked by Oren in the chat there if it's legal in Australia. The answer is absolutely not. Not even close. We don't even have, I don't even think we have the medical marijuana thing.
Here's another thing. Canada's really on the ball. Okay, last year the Canada it's legal assisted suicide is legal here in Canada as of last June. So this is big too. You guys got legalized assisted suicide?
It's gonna be next year in
Oh, yeah. Okay.
one state. I heard in Victoria.
Oh, really?
I'm in Queensland.
I got
But
the paper here, and it says "Dying with Dignity." It's under our bill. It's Bill C-14. It was legalized June 17th of last year. What happens is they have to have two independent healthcare professionals need to evaluate the individual in order to determine whether he or she qualifies. You must be over 18, have a serious and incurable illness, disease or disability, endure physical or psychological suffering that is intolerable to them. Their natural death has become reasonably foreseeable. So I'm just thinking about a lot of people like look at Robin Williams. He suffered from that dementia, but they couldn't even like diagnose him with that until he did his autopsy, right?
Jeff, last week there was a story come out in the Australian news. There was a guy, he was 104, and he still was in, what do you call it, decent peace of mind or whatever you call it. And he traveled to some country from Australia. He traveled from some country to do the assisted suicide or whatever, not suicide.
Yeah.
And yeah, he got put out of his misery, so to speak. He was in decent, sound mind, and he was 104, and he j had just had enough of life.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and he chose it. He had a couple of people around him. He didn't have any family out, lived these kids and this and that, whatever. And he went to some country. I can't remember which country it was, but anyway. He handed his life, and he didn't want to wait till next year or the year after
Okay.
to do it in one of the states in Australia.
So
But we're pretty
here's
be
the
we're pretty
problem.
behind, man. We don't we're the
Well,
last ones to get any of this shit, you know.
here's the problem with Canada. Now, Canada's got these people in the States, because it's not legal. Assisted suicide is not legal in the States.
Yeah.
Well, most. I think there might be. I'm not sure. I'm not 100% sure, but there might be a couple of states where it is. I'm not sure on that. But most states, it's illegal to commit, assisted suicide.
Yeah.
So you got these people from some people from the states that have tramped come to Canada to get this done, right? But it's a what process, like you said, like it says here, you have to get you have to qualify for it. That's kind of fucking funny, eh? Qualify to get killed, eh?
Yeah, fuck, I just fucked up.
Don't care.
I just fucked
Yeah.
up something. I just fucked up something. I didn't record OBS when I started. I'm gonna have to I'm gonna have to record my Periscope now. Fuck, that's a pain in the ass, eh?
OBS. What do you mean by that?
Well, the recording, so I can post it. I didn't fucking record. But anyway, it's okay. I'll get it off my Periscope, I guess. It can be done. Yeah. It's just a
anyway.
Pain.
I thought that was interesting.
It is. But the are you thinking maybe like maybe buy a little bit of the marijuana every now and then?
I would, but like I said, I wouldn't.
What about the edibles? I tried the edibles.
I wouldn't be taking too much of it. I used to have like a little bit will last me a long time. I'll just take like a couple of puffs and put it out, and that, and it kind of helps me with like writing songs and stuff with my, playing guitar and stuff.
Yeah.
Like it opens. I find it opens up your mind though. It does open up your mind. But I can't take too much of it or it'll fuck me up.
I'd like to try the edibles or whatever it is. The edibles.
Yeah, I've never tried them.
Do you remember when Danny?
Yeah, they have like them in like gummy bears and.
Do you remember when Danny had too many? Remember? And he fucking.
They say they're really powerful. They say you gotta watch yourself.
Yeah, yeah. I'd like to try one. You know, because I'm not a smoker.
And you can even get the liquid stuff and put it in your vapor. You know.
Yeah, but I don't vape. I don't vape or smoke, so I'm looking for something a different way. I'd like to get high a different way.
There's all kinds of different ways you can. There's cookies and muffins. You can go in like in the shop. There's all kind. You can eat it, right?
Yeah.
You don't have to smoke it.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I said, the gummy bears. They chew on them and it gets you fucked up.
Yeah. I'd like to do, but you know, the thing is now, Jeff. I don't know if they got it over there, but. When you get pulled up by the police, they got like they're now testing for drugs as well.
That's another problem there's a huge discussion about that in Canada. They're really worried about that. There's a whole discussion about that and about different procedures that the police are going to have to do because it's going to be a whole, it's going to fuck up the courts. They're gonna have to start making new laws about smoking and driving now. Mm. You know, and they're gonna not only that, they're gonna have to develop new tests. And what is the person's individual right that they're gonna have to come up with something to like? You know, they got the breathalyzer. They can detect how much the cop pulls you over. He's got a breathalyzer in his car, right?
Yep.
He can make you blow into that. So with pot, you can't make the guy to go to the hospital and get a needle and take blood and like that's against your rights.
Yeah. They got the breathalyzers here they have the old traditional blow in there till they tell you to stop, but they also have the ones that you just talk into now. And they can apparently detect friggin' marijuana and they're also expanding them to test for other things too, like friggin' crack, mm-hmm. crack and stuff like
that's what they're coming up with, some kind of different tests, and right, but then they're gonna have to spend a lot of money on like having these new tests in every police cruiser. And
have you got this other thing where they're trying to stop people from texting and driving, right? So they fine people, you lose
it's a
points.
Huge fine.
Yeah, it's huge everywhere, right? But they're now saying that they're trying to come up with a technology to disable your phone when you're driving. As far as the thing is, I don't know how they're going to do it, but what about like I use my phone to Bluetooth and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
So I don't know whether they're serious, and they're also coming up with a cop car's coming towards you, and they got the radar. They can detect, how fast you're going if you're coming towards them, and then they can, either take a picture or chase you and find you. They reckon that they're coming out with technology where they can tell whether or not you're using your phone.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Have you heard of that?
No.
Yeah, apparently that's what I've been reading, so I don't know.
Well, our technology is just starting to pick up really fast. Things are like, even with these phones, there's so much stuff that the technology is just, it's crazy,
Yeah, yeah.
The stuff you can get,
Oh, man, I wake up with it, during the night with a fucking terrible headache. I took 3 Nurofen, but I'm still feeling the effects of it now.
When are you taking holidays, or do you got your holidays already booked, or?
Which holidays you mean?
I'm thinking I'll try and take a week in July and a week in August.
Ah, is that just what you like to do?
It's the warm, two warmest months for us are July and August.
Yeah, I'm just wondering, I got chat open here with my Scope. There's someone in there called Beth by Kiss, and I love their comments. They're a very, very intelligent person. I'm just wondering, do I know you from anywhere, or... Because I feel like it's someone I know, but if that person may not want to tell me, but yeah, I like their comments. It reminds me of like an Ava or someone like that. But anyway, so Fancy was writing to me in Skype here telling me, he says he's coming from a rave from last night, was out the whole night. I'm still drunk and half sleepy. Could you imagine Fancy at a rave? Are you shitting me?
Yeah, I can see him at a rave. I've seen him. I've seen him on his periscopes getting down, dancing away.
You reckon?
Yeah.
Can you just see him dancing to Funky Town?
I'm laughing. I'm laughing in my head right now. Just thinking about it.
Right? Yeah. Oh, I don't know.
I'm not into that anymore. I'm too old to get into like.
Jeff, you're never
too
old.
Clubs and all that shit. Fuck, man.
You're never too old, Jeff. You know, they did a survey saying that if you sleep between, they reckon between 7 and 8 hours is the ideal sleeping time. And they reckon if you undersleep consistently, it's very bad for your mortality, they reckon. If you undersleep consistently. So, like, you know, people that don't sleep much during the week and then catch up on the weekend, they reckon it's not very healthy. So, I can sleep. I can sleep forever, man.
It's healthier to be on a regular program.
Yeah, know? I get about 7 hours a night.
You should be on a regular program of getting up and going to bed and eating too. Should be on a proper. But most people don't follow. Proper schedule, but I think it's healthier for your body, you know.
Fancy said he'd be back on in 10 minutes when he was on last time, but I think the 10 minutes is up. I don't think he's going to catch us.
All right,
we should test the Discord though, you know, that would be good.
Yeah,
although yeah, I got things to do too. I have to wash up. I got a fixed got a clothesline, one of those clotheslines that bolted to the side of the house. You know, it's not like an old fashioned one. It's one of the new sort of style ones. And all the clips and all that are all broken. That where the line is strung. So I had to buy all new clips. And I need to spend an hour fixing it up because only half the lines work. So I've got that to do, and I haven't washed.
Well, we've been on here for 45 minutes now. Before you had, did you do your intro and all that?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, did you talk a little bit before I came on?
Oh yeah, I was talking for ages.
Oh okay.
That's why I was waiting because
I was waiting for you to type in and say, yeah, Jeff, yeah, all
yeah,
in now.
Yeah, yeah. You didn't have the Scope open. I realize that now. Because I said twice, Jeff, call me when you're ready, you know, and then nothing. I kept talking. I was talking about my internet and all that sort of shit. So.
Oh, okay.
But no, that's fine. I was just going to give it a bit longer to see whether Fancy was going to come back on. See, I want to hear about this rave. But Fancy's version of 10 minutes could be anything, couldn't it? So.
That's funny.
Are you on your weekend? Are you on your weekend? Off, or is this your long weekend?
I'm going tomorrow. I work Sunday to Thursday.
Oh, so okay, yeah. So it's next weekend. It's okay.
I usually have a couple of drinks for, not too much. I usually have a couple of drinks on Saturday. But I'm not. Actually, before you even got a hold of me, I was watching. I was watching the JonBenet movie. I never, that came on. You know, JonBenet, remember that kid that got murdered?
Yeah.
Back in 96.
Are you still trying to catch up with Agent Mark?
No, I haven't. I haven't tried to catch up with him. He told me, the last tweet he sent me, he said, try and get a hold of me on, actually, today's Saturday. It's just Saturdays are his best days, so I was just chilling out. I was just not doing anything. Just sometimes you just, I had a couple on, when I got off work on Thursday, I had a couple beers, but I haven't had any sense of just chilling, just relaxing. Eh? Just catching up on stuff. I was catching up on some programs that I haven't. There's one program that I like to watch called Cyrus. It's about these mermaids. I don't know. I won't get into it, but it just gives me a chance to catch up on some of these programs that I like. Survivor too. I watched Survivor. They had the season finale on Wednesday, but I don't get a chance to watch these shows sometimes, right? Because I'm busy working.
Oh, man, I watch a lot of stuff. I download stuff every week. I've got a folder full of
shit. Did you TiVo all that shit?
No, I don't have TiVo. I just download.
I don't have TiVo either, but I have. It's something different with my Rogers cable. I got a different system.
I just download it off the internet, most of my shows, because I save them. But a lot of stuff I save on the Foxtel, like if I'm not here, so something that's on free to air, like V8 Racing or something like that, or footy games or something. I've got all that preset, you know, to record in there. So there's stuff like that. But I download like Westworld, and I watch all sorts of Designated Survivor. I watch lots of stuff, The Colony. I love heaps of shows. American shows, most of the stuff, but. I love all that sort of stuff, you know, Walking Dead or Fear the Walking Dead, and I watch them all. I love them. I don't know where I get the time, man. I don't know.
I usually try and do something on, you know, my time off, but I just didn't feel like doing anything. I wanted to go. Now and then I like to go up to the CN Tower.
Yeah.
And. Every time I've gone up, I've just gone up to the bar area or the dining lounge. But they have this edge walk, and I've always wanted to do that. And it's $225 though. And then they do the video and everything for you.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really so it's really high. Well, the CN Tower is the third largest freestanding structure in the world, eh? Yeah. It's 553 meters high.
Okay.
And we have the Ripley's Aquarium. It's the largest indoor aquarium. And it's they got like 16,000 animals. They got sharks, stingrays, you know. Yeah, that's the admission for that is $76. So I was thinking about I was gonna do that, but I just, you know, maybe next weekend.
How's your brother doing? Is he all good? All good? Everything going good?
Yeah, he's not too bad.
Not too bad.
He has his ups and downs, right? Mm-hmm. You know, as long as he's taking his medication, he's fine.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
Let me know next time I know you're not a Rabbit fan, but you do use Rabbit if you can.
Like I said, if I do go in there, I'll just go into my own room and I'll just invite whoever I want and whoever wants to show up, whatever. Like I said, if I get a hold of, like, if Agent Mudd or whatever, I'd like to have a chat with him. You know, I haven't talked to him in a long time, so
I want to talk to Mark too about, like.
Yeah, so like when I do that, I'll like I said, that was like almost 3 weeks ago or something when I did that, right?
And that's the last time I went in there. I think was
it your. That's room? The last time I've been in there.
Hmm.
You know,
there's something going on there. There's something going in there now. Or something funny going on in there now.
I get invites every day though.
I turn mine every off. Day.
My email is full of people inviting me. So
who invites you? Must be the cat that invites you.
Mush, the cat, a lot of Joe's people, because they like. Yeah, I used to go into Joe's room and used to like we'd fight back and forth, eh? But you know, he likes that, right? It's like I give him content, right? I'd play some music and stuff. He'd always want to challenge me to karaoke. Or he as soon as I go into open up a room, he'd always be in there, you know. I don't block him or anything. That's another thing. Like people would get mad at me if, oh, well, how come you don't got that Joe guy blocked? They said, you know what? Unless he's doxing me or shit, he, you know, like they're saying, oh, he doxes people, and they, oh, he doesn't do any of that shit to me. So, you know, I fight with him and argue with him. No,
Yeah,
it's
you
like,
do. You do.
yeah. So, anyways, I got a lot of his people because they want to see me go in there and fight with him, and I don't know, concerned citizen, you know, all of those guys that hang out. Like most of them, I'm getting invites from people that I don't even know. I don't even know who this person is. I don't know. I'm not just most of the time, I just don't have time for it. A lot, most of the time, like working through the week, right?
And I'm gambling.
Most of them are doing them real late, and I'll be in bed sleeping. I gotta get up early and go to work, you know?
I'm trying to gamble less these days, so I'm spending a lot more time at home doing
Oh,
stuff.
yeah. See, I used to be addicted to gambling on the horses.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I haven't done that in a long time, though. That was my addiction when it came to gambling. The horses.
You can spend, I guess you
Triax
can
and all
spend
that.
I guess you can spend a lot of money on them too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You know, that's the problem when you win. When you win a few times, you think you can do it all the time, and you can't. It doesn't work out that way. You know, like one night I went and I won $800, right? And then I went back the next night and I won $500. And then I said, oh, geez, I can do this all the time. No, you can't. And I go back the next night and I fucking lose a shitload of money. You know? Lose everything, you end up winning.
Well, that's normally what happens.
Oh,
So.
yeah. But anyways, I don't. It doesn't look like Fancy's coming around.
No, I
Right?
sent him a message, but he didn't.
But where you're up, you're coming up to your hour mark. We usually cut it off at hour. I think we got to stick to our rule.
Yeah, man. I'll end it now. But thanks for coming on. I'm
Hey,
sorry.
no problem.
I'm sorry it took me a while to get set up. But
Hey, yeah,
I'm still not happy. I've got it. I don't think I've got it 100% yet. But hopefully, it's not coming out too bad. I can't really play it back while I'm talking because I get the feedback goes back through and it stuffs it up. So basically, I'm just talking. I test it before I go live.
yeah.
And then when I go live, I really don't know what I sound like. So I'm hoping it comes through okay. But anyway, thanks for joining
Okay.
me. Thanks for joining me, buddy. And
Yeah, we'll see you next week.
let's do you want to do next weekend? Let's test the Discord thing. And we'll
Yeah,
yeah,
that's
is
what I
that
want.
yeah,
Okay.
okay. All right, buddy. Take
Okay,
care.
take care, man.
All right, bye-bye. All right. Thank you, Jeff, for coming on. Thanks for everybody for listening either live or the replay. And let's go out with a little bit of
Traveling in a fighter combi.
Thanks, everybody. Anyway.
On a hippie trailhead full of zombies.
Catch that out.
I met a strange lady. She made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land down under?